Bandwidth for this podcast is brought to you by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Play artist, right on dynamite.
Playing artist, right on dynamite. MP3 music search, only on Ford, Lincoln, and Mercury vehicles. Sync, say the word.
So I'm here at Connects, and these guys have solved a big problem that I have had, and so I hope that you're interested in it. It may seem simple, but some of you are just going to go, oh! So what you have here is this is a mini DisplayPort. This is what all our computers are coming out with now, to HDMI. So if you have your standard television, that you wanted to drop over, you can basically connect this straight to a standard television from your Mac Pro, from your MacBook Pro, you know, all of those things that have a DisplayPort out only, which is all we have now, we can very easily get to. This is only like $20. So you can get out to it. Now, there's a couple other connections that are available. So here's a little bit more of a complex situation. Well, let me show you this one first. So here you have a connection. Now this one is your DisplayPort. So you have a DisplayPort here, and then you have USB. Now what that's going to do is that's going to give you stereo audio along with with the video, and that's going to go into the HDMI. So that's going to carry all of that into the television. So if you want to hook up your laptop to the television and get sound, because the first one's only going to give you the video, this one's going to give you sound in basic stereo. Now if you have a Toslink, what you can actually do here is, this is a little bit bigger. Now that one was about $60, this one's about $70, and what this allows you to do is you can get basic sound and video that you saw before, but you can also get 5.1 if you've got this connection. Mac Minis have this. So if you really want to hook it up and get all you can, you know, be all you can be, this is the connection for you. Now, some of you are going to want to go the other way. You've got a 27-inch iMac and you want to connect your Sony PlayStation to it. You can see one right over here. So you want to hook your Sony there. Well, here is going the other direction. So what you have is HDMI in and a DisplayPort out. Now, this is going to be about $150, but it is going to be well worth it. I know that a lot of this seems kind of silly sometimes for some of you because you don't have to deal with all of this stuff. But for those of us who have a lot of different monitors, have a lot of different computers, being able to get this mini DisplayPort to all these other monitors is key, and Connects is the way to go.